Hey guys, in this video we're going to check out how to change the length of background music for your YouTube videos. A lot of times, finding music that's the right style and length for a video you're working on can be very difficult, so it's helpful to be able to change the length. For this video, we'll do this in both Audacity for people who are looking for a free option, and Adobe Audition, which is paid software but is also much easier to use. For the sound source, I'm using Hook Sounds. This is a site with a lot of free music that you can use for your videos. They just ask that you give them credit, or you can purchase a license for some of the music if you don't want to give credit. To check out their music, I've put a link in the video description down below. There's lots of different sources of background music, so just pick a song you like, no matter what the length, and work with that. As for the song, this one I'm using is called Beyond Reality. Let's start off with Audacity. Start by importing the track. Then make a duplicate of the file on the second track. Now press F5 to select the time shift tool. We're going to drag the second track later on the timeline. A lot of background music has different layers and repetitive sections. Our goal is to line up these two tracks so that what is playing is similar but at different points in time. To make sure this works, we can then play them back together. This song is a good example since it's very easy to see the different sections and the beat through the waveform view. Once we have the time where we want to cut, we select the end of the first track and use the delete function. Then we use the split delete function under Remove Special on the Edit menu to do the same for the first part of the second track. This prevents it from time shifting. Now select the overlapping portions of both tracks. Go to the Effects menu and select Crossfade Tracks. This fades out the first track and fades in the second. Before applying it, I switch the curve to Constant Power 1, otherwise there will be a dip in volume. Now we can listen back and we hear that there is a seamless transition, so we've increased the length of our song. You can do this multiple times or at different positions in the song to get a different length. If you have access to Adobe Audition, you can do this automatically with the new version. For more control, I still like to manually increase the length of the music. Once again, we line up the files on two different tracks. The whole process is quite a bit easier in Adobe Audition. Just drag the ends of the clip to trim it. Then drag the bottom clip on top of the top track and it will automatically create a crossfade. Then we just export the entire multi-track mix down to a new file so we can open it with the editing software. I like to keep all these in a folder and label them by song name and approximate length since I end up reusing them for future projects. Thanks for checking out this video on changing song length in Audacity and Adobe Audition to make it fit your videos. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like and subscribe to the channel. You can also follow us on our social media links to keep up to date on all our new content.